You're listening to Saturday Morning Media. And now, back to our show.
Attraction Checklist is made possible by the Saturday Morning Media Patreon patrons. Not only do patrons get to hear these shows up to a week in advance before their release, they also get special downloads of just the recorded attraction audio for each episode, and they get exclusive bonus episodes about attractions from other theme parks. Consider becoming a patron today for as little as a dollar a month over at patreon.com/Saturday Morning Media. And thank you for your support.
My name is Grant Pachoco, and I invite you to join me on my quest to learn about and experience every Disney park attraction I possibly can. This is Attraction Checklist.
Welcome to Attraction Checklist. This episode takes us to Disney's Animal Kingdom in Walt Disney World to experience the park's nighttime spectacular, Rivers of Light. The guide map describes this show by saying, "Surrender to the beauty and harmony of all living things during this music-filled spectacle of water, light, and legend." This is an all-ages attraction, and FastPass Plus is offered. Now, before we hear the show, here are five fast facts about Rivers of Light at Disney's Animal Kingdom. 1. First announced in October of 2013, Rivers of Light officially opened at Disney's Animal Kingdom on February 17, 2017. It had been originally planned to open on April 22, 2016, but technical difficulties prevented it from doing so. 2. The 15-minute-long show is unique in that it is a Disney park spectacular that features no fireworks. The reason for this is because the fireworks would scare the animals that call the park home. 3. The animals that live at Disney's Animal Kingdom also got a sneak preview of Rivers of Light before anyone else. For months before the show opened, the soundtrack of the show, along with pre-recorded audience noise, was played as the park's animals were bedding down for the night, so they could get used to the new sounds in their environment. 4. The music for Rivers of Light was composed by the team of Don Harper, Mark Mancina, and Dave Metzger, with lyrics by Miriam Stockley, who also performed some of the chants during the show. And 5. The show's unique animal barges that float around the lagoon on Discovery River do not have drivers aboard, as they are remotely controlled. Well, now it's time to experience Rivers of Light. Joining me for the show is John B. DeHaas, and after the show, we'll give you our thoughts on this attraction. Now, this is a binaural recording, so if you have headphones, put them on now as we experience Rivers of Light at Disney's Animal Kingdom.
Most welcome guests. In just a few moments, Rivers of Light, a celebration of nature's wonder told through music, water, and light, will begin. Throughout this evening's event, the amphitheater's lighting will be significantly lower, along with moments of darkness. For everyone's safety, we kindly ask that you please remain seated and keep the aisles completely clear until the theater's lighting returns following this evening's celebration. Also, smoking, flash photography, and the use of laser pointers is strictly prohibited. Thank you for your understanding.
Bienvenidos invitados. En pocos momentos, Rivers of Light, una celebración de vida, dicho por medio de música, agua y luz, comenzará. Durante el evento de esta noche, la iluminación del anfiteatro será bastante bajo y a veces momentos de oscuridad. Para la seguridad de todos, les rogamos que por favor permanezcan sentados y mantengan los pasillos libres hasta que vuelva la iluminación teatral después de la celebración de esta noche. Además, el fumar, la fotografía con flash y el uso de punteros laser están estrictamente prohibidos. Gracias por su comprensión.
Thank you. Thank you. beings and all living things. Here, where fire and water bridge the earth and sky, our light rises on the wind to join the stars. As we journey on this great earth, may we remember the light we share. May we celebrate our bond with the natural world and the wonders that flow on rivers of light.
Que hayan disfrutado Rivers of Light. Ahora rogamos que por favor recojan sus pertenencias. Vayan a la parte trasera del anfiteatro en este momento. Por su seguridad, por favor, no caminen a través de los bancos. Les damos las gracias por su cooperación y les deseamos un resto de su viaje seguro y agradable.
Well, John, we just watched Rivers of Light here at Disney's Animal Kingdom, and this is the first time I saw it.
Me as well.
And what did you think?
Yeah. First time and last time I have to see it.
Well, I'll tell you this. I saw a lot of... I liked it better than I thought I was going to like it, because I went in like, oh, I'm not going to like this at all. And then... watching it, there were certain elements. I like the shadow puppetry. They did a lot of shadow puppetry on the water and on the sails. They did a really neat effect where the woman on the barge held out her hand and an eagle or a bird looked like it landed on her arm, but there was no bird. Like, it was all done via shadow. I thought that was cool. I did think it was very funny that there was, this is the America section with grizzly bears and the bald eagle and wolves.
Yeah.
But yeah, I'm not a big show person, and I didn't think that there was a big wow moment.
Oh, no. It was kind of cool things, like the lotus flowers when I opened up and had projections in front of those. That was kind of cool, but I just sat there going, eh? I was waiting for something really, really cool to happen. It just kind of was like, oh, okay.
Yeah.
I do think it's interesting. It's like we've got four actors in this whole show.
Yeah, that's all. Well, I thought when they originally cast it and opened it, or way, way back when it was supposed to open, I'm kind of thinking there's at least 8 or 16 dancers that they hired. I had friends who were supposed to be doing it, and then it got pushed back and pushed back and pushed back, and then the Jungle Book show opened last year.
Yeah.
Then this one finally opened. I guess there's only 4.
Yeah.
I see 4 actors on these boats going by.
Yeah, well, it was, as I said, I liked it better than I thought I would. Yeah. I won't be seeing it again, probably.
No.
Unless somebody really wanted to see it that I was with.
Yeah, I mean, it's good to come to the last show because you just walk in and see it.
Yeah, that was great. There's plenty of seating. I don't know if that's good or bad.
Yeah.
So, John, your rating scale.
Oh,
let's have
boy.
It.
2 bald eagles out of 5 frogs.
There you go. All right, John, thank you very much.
Thanks.
Do you agree or disagree with our thoughts on this attraction? Or do you just want to let me know what attraction we should go on next? Send me an email at hello@saturdaymorningmedia.com, or you can let me know via Twitter, where my username is Toasterboy, or post on the Attraction Checklist Facebook page at facebook.com/attraction checklist. This episode was edited by Steven Staver. Attraction Checklist is a production of Saturday Morning Media and made possible by the Saturday Morning Media Patreon patrons who've gone to patreon.com/Saturday Morning Media and set up a monthly pledge for as little as $1 a month. Patrons get new episodes before they are released, downloads of the ride audio recorded for each episode, and exclusive bonus episodes featuring attractions from other theme parks. If you'd like to support this show and the other fun content from Saturday Morning Media, become a patron. Head on over to patreon.com/Saturday Morning Media and set up your monthly pledge today. You can also tell a friend about the show or leave the show a review on Apple Podcasts, Spotify, Google Play, or wherever you get your podcasts. Thank you so much for listening. Attraction Checklist is copyright 2019 Saturday Morning Media, Grant Pachoco, executive producer, all rights reserved. www.saturdaymorningmedia.com. You've been listening to Saturday Morning Media. Stay tuned. We'll be right back.